joining the army. That weekend, he was on leave and able to help out.
Joe was there to protect, the station and the family and make sure no one got hurt and to try to keep the peace.
14-year-old Elliot documented the events on home video.
My dad had asked me to keep the camera running in case real trouble broke out. We needed something to show the cops.
I felt sorry, but it was like it was our fault, and it's not our fault. Now we're just trying to run a business, and all of a sudden we're looked at as the enemy, and so that really scared me.
The devastation at Port Fouchon had left the nation with a shortfall of over 10% of its daily intake of oil.
When you're experiencing a 2 million barrel shortfall per day, that's 14 million in a week. Unless you make up the shortage, it will affect everybody. The mother driving kids to school. The teamster driving meat to a wholesaler. Our ability to fly individuals from one part of the country to the next because our airline industry is so dependent on them. I wanted to prevent that by utilizing the Strategic Petroleum Reserve.
The Strategic Petroleum Reserve, or SPR, was established after the oil crisis of the 1970s. By 2005, it stockpiled 700 million barrels of oil and was considered an emergency option for presidents facing a shortage. To release the SPR was a big decision.
A formal announcement was made at 9 o'clock this morning that 1 million barrels of oil will be released from the Strategic Petroleum Reserve every day for the next month.
This will be a loan from the government to the private oil companies. We expect that with this release, it will relieve the pressure on the markets and reduce the sense of panic.
The government action did just that. Within hours, the price of oil dropped below $70. But the SPR was only a short-term solution to the crisis. With the reconstruction of Port Fouchon just beginning, the only answer was for America to look beyond its own borders for supplies of oil.
When you have as an abrupt a shortfall as we did, there's only one country that you can look to for help. That's Saudi Arabia.
Saudi Arabia holds over a quarter of the world's oil reserves. It was the only country capable of increasing supply without delay.
After much discussion, it was decided that we would send Sasha Sanger, the president's chief foreign affairs advisor, to Riyadh. He had built up a very special relationship with the Saudi family.
I have known Al-Naimi for 10 years. He's a friend. So he will do for me things that he will perhaps not do for Jack Roden or even for President Bush, whom he does not know so well. It is all personal relationships. They are very important in these.
Tensions between the Saudi royal family and fundamentalist agitators have been running high.
In Saudi Arabia, outside the royal family, America is not popular. The Osama bin Laden, the fundamentalists, they hate America. And many ordinary Saudis have some sympathy. And for a Saudi government official, for a Saudi prince, to help America in time of trouble is a risk.
Despite this, the Saudis agreed to increase their supply to the U.S. from 2 million to 3 million barrels a day. But while Americans struggle to refuel their cars, far more serious events were unfolding in the Middle East, which would rock the entire nation.
Breaking news out of Dammam, Saudi Arabia, where Islamic militants have seized control of a shopping mall.
Unconfirmed reports suggest that over 300 Westerners were being held hostage by suspected Islamic fundamentalists.
My heart sank when I heard the news. And I thought it might have something to do with Sasha Sanamir's deal with the Saudis. And it turned out I was right. the fundamentalists do not want to have the Saudi royal family dealing with the United States.
It was particularly terrible for me because as soon as it had happened, I realized I should have expected it.
The fear of Saudi Arabia collapsing into chaos sent a shockwave through the markets. Petrol prices skyrocketed.
Oh, I'll never forget that moment. My broker called me up.
That's how it works when you run a gas station. Your broker calls you every day and they tell you what prices to put up.
And the number that came out of his mouth, I thought I had to be here in a moment.
After Hurricane Julia, the oil crisis took a desperate turn when Islamic terrorists in Saudi Arabia took 300 Western oil workers hostage at gunpoint.
Breaking news this morning. The Al Rashid Mall in the Eastern Province is now under the control of an armed militia calling itself...
Western oil workers are said to be held hostage in this building.
We had become accustomed to attacks on Western oil workers in the Middle East, but the scenes that unfolded that day, we were not prepared for.
My heart just dropped. It was really quite an emotional experience for me, because we've had so many workers over in Saudi Arabia for so many years.